وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى in this session I want to speak about أحكام, rulings and regulations pertaining to Zakatul Fitr. هيا حاتم مستر
أبو, what is the wisdom behind Zakatul Fitr?
Okay, the wisdom behind Zakatul Fitr and the reason why it was legislated, because brothers and sisters, what I want us to all understand, Ibrahim, Talha, and Hatim, I want us to all understand, is everything Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us to do, there is a wisdom behind it. There is a wisdom behind it. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala tells us to do something, there is a wisdom behind it. So the wisdom, inshaAllah Ta'ala, Ibrahim is going to share the hadith with us, and then inshaAllah Ta'ala, I'm going to get out from the hadith the wisdom, inshaAllah Ta'ala. Ibrahim, read for us hadith Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah.
فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر طهرة للصائم من اللغو والرفث وطعمة للمساكين، فمن أداها قبل الصلاة فهي زكاة مقبولة، ومن أداها بعد الصلاة فهي صدقة من الصدقات. أخرجه أبو داود وابن ماجه من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما، وصححه الألباني في صحيح الجامع.
So this hadith, inshallah ta'ala, hadith ibn Abbas, tells us the wisdom and the hikmah behind Zakatul Fitri. What does it mention? It mentions two wisdoms. It mentions how many wisdoms?
Two wisdoms.
Two wisdoms. The first wisdom, the first hikmah, the wisdom in Zakatul Fitr is what? It's طُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ مِنَ اللَّغْوِ وَالرَّفَثِ. The person who's fasting, there are some mistakes that he did. Things that he shouldn't have said, he said. Okay? He did things that he shouldn't have done. Mistakes, shortcomings, errors. What does it do for you, Zakatul Fitri? It purifies that for him. طُهْرَةً لِلصَّائِمِ. The one who's fasting, it purifies his fasting for him from the little mistakes and shortcomings. The second wisdom is what? وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. Our brothers and sisters who are poor, what does it do? The money we give them, the zakat we give them, I mean the food that we give them, they can have Eid with us that day, right? And the issue of money, can it be given instead of food? We'll come to that, inshallah ta'ala. They're going to have Eid with us. They're going to have something to eat. They're not going to be poor that day. So it's also what? وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. Those are the two wisdoms which is mentioned in the hadith that Ibrahim benefited us with. Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He tells us in Surah Al-Bayyinah, Allah says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا
إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ.
So in this ayah, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, what does He tell us? That every action that we do, we have to do with what? With ikhlas and sincerity. And the Muslims, what are they to each other? We Muslims are what? Brothers and sisters. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hujurat,
Innama al-mu'minuna ikhwatun fa'aslihu bayna akhawaykum wattaqullaha la'allakum turhamun.
Jazakallahu khairan. Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala that verily the believers are what?
Brothers and sisters.
We love each other. So that's why we help each other. So Zakatul Fitri is a way to unite the Muslims, to aid and support one another. All of those are what? From the wisdoms of why Zakatul Fitri was legislated. Okay, does that make sense?
Yeah.
Are you? Yes, Talha.
What is the ruling of Zakatul Fitri?
The ruling of Zakatul Fitri is that it's obligatory on every single person. It's what the scholars call Fardu'ayn. What is Fardu'ayn? Fardu Ayn means every single person has to pay Zakatul Fitri. And for Zakatul Fitri to be obligatory on you, two conditions have to be there. How many conditions? Two conditions have to be there, and then it becomes an individual obligation, meaning an obligation on everybody. The first condition is Shartul Islam. The person has to be what?
Muslim.
The person has to be a Muslim. And this is based on the hadith of Ibn Umar. Can you share the hadith with us, inshaAllah ta'ala?
فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر صاعا من تمر أو صاعا من شعير على العبد والحر والذكر والأنثى والصغير والصغير والكبير من المسلمين وأمر بها أن تؤدى قبل خروج الناس إلى الصلاة أخرجه البخاري ومسلم من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما.
This hadith, as you can see, it mentions فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر على العبد والحر والذكر والأنثى والصغير والكبير من المسلمين. So the first condition is what? They have to be Muslims. The people who the Zakatul Fitr is obligatory on
have to be Muslims.
They have to be Muslims. Because that qayd, Ibn Umar's hadith, that restriction, min al Muslimin, is what? It shows, Talha, it shows what? That they have to be Muslimin. Okay. The second condition is that Shartul Qudrah, they have to have the ability. They have to have what?
The ability.
Because in our religion, لِأَنَّ غَيْرَ الْقَادِرِ, the one who doesn't have the ability, who hasn't got the strength to do something, in the Sharia is what? مَرْفُوعٌ عَنْهُ الْحَرَجِ. The obligation is uplifted from that person. Allah says in the ayah, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. In Surah Al-Hajj, Allah says, وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجِ. Does that make sense? So the person, if he hasn't got the ability based on those two verses, the ruling is lifted from them. If they don't have the ability. And the Sharia always restricts, it connects ruling to what?
To have the ability.
Ability. The person has to have the ability.
What's your question?
If someone's a abd and he doesn't have the ability, and if someone is saghir and they don't have the ability, do they still have to give zakat al-fitri?
So Ibrahim, mashallah, your question is very strong. It's a very good question that you asked. And it's what the scholars call al-ma'niyuna bi zakat al-fitri. Who are the people who are the ones who have to pay zakat al-fitri? Okay?
Okay.
Who are the ones who have to pay the zakat al-fitri? Okay? The person has to first of all pay zakat al-fitri from themselves. You start with yourself. That's why the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hadith Sahih Muslim, min hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ibda bi nafsika, start with yourself. The person has to start with who?
So.
Themselves. So the zakat al-fitr, first pay for yourself. And the second, you have to pay for who?
Family.
Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in another hadith, al-Imam Muslim narrated min hadith Hakim ibn Hizam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, what did the Prophet say? He said, wabda biman ta'ul. What does that mean? Also, start with, after yourself, the people that you take care of financially.
So though
my wife, my children, my parents, I have to pay for them. So the children, who is the one who pays for them?
The father.
Their father. Because you fall under the people that I take care of. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So every single one of you don't have to pay Zakat al-Fitri. Even that the Zakat al-Fitri is what? It must be paid on behalf of you. But who is the obligation on here?
The father.
It's on the father to take care of that and to pay for it. Does that make sense? Hey, Ibrahim.
If someone's a abd, how do they pay?
The Sayyid pays for that. The master pays for the abd. The master is upon him now to pay for it. The children, the father pays for it. Okay? So this hadith, al-ma'niyuna bi zakati al-fitri, are who? Those people. So if the person doesn't have enough money to pay Zakat al-Fitri, who does he pay for? He pays for himself first. If anything's left, then he pays for his wife. هي طلحة ما شاء الله.
What's your دليل for what you said?
The دليل for what I said ما شاء الله. إبراهيم إن شاء الله is gonna share the hadith for us بإذن الله الكريم for the evidence of those people who have to pay the zakat al-fitr.
أمر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بصدقة الفطر عن الصغير والكبير والحر والعبد مما تمنون. أخرجه الدارقطني والبيهقي من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما وحسنه الألباني في إلواء الغليل.
This hadith summarizes what I just said, which is that you have to pay zakat al-fitr for who? For yourself. That's number one.
Yourself.
So you start with yourself. I mentioned the hadith of Jabir رضي الله تعالى, Jabir ibn Abdullah رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Okay, which says ابدأ بنفسك. Start with yourself. And then after that, who do you have to pay for after you've paid for yourself? The hadith of Hakim ibn Hizam. في صحيح مسلم, what does it say? وابدأ بمن تعول. Pay for
your family
members, your wife, your children, etc. On top of what Ibrahim mentioned, some people think if they divorce their wives and they let their wives go and she's pregnant, that they don't have to give the zakat al-fitri on behalf of his divorced wife and the child that she's bearing. And in the Sharia, the man has to still provide, because the wife that you divorced who is pregnant, you have to still provide for her, right?
Yeah.
You still have to provide for her, and that also falls under وَبْدَأْ بِمَنْ تَعُولُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Al-Talaq, قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَإِن كُنَّ
أُولَاتِ حَمْلٍ فَأَنْفِقُوا عَلَيْنَّ حَتَّى يَضَعْنَ حَمْلَهُنَّ.
So based on this ayah, Jazakallahu khayran, Allah says, وَإِن كُنَّ أُولَاتِ حَمْلٍ, if the wife is pregnant, she's carrying a child, Allah says, فَأَنْفِقُوا, provide for her, right? So she still gets the zakat al-fitr paid for and the child that she's carrying. Okay? She has to get the zakat al-fitr, has to be paid on her behalf. Does that make sense? Hatim.
Abu, when do you have to pay zakat al-fitr?
MashaAllah. Zakat al-fitr, the timing in which it's paid, the scholars have differed in it. For us to look at this matter, Hatim and Talha and Ibrahim, for us to look at this issue and really get to the bottom of it, we have to divide the issue of timing into three. How many categories do we have to divide it into?
Three.
The first is, when does the time of the obligation of Zakat al-Fitr start? Does that make sense? يعني بداية وقت وجوب زكاة الفطر. When does the obligation of zakat al-fitr start? And there are two views in this mas'ala. When does it start? The starting time. There are too many, how many views? Two views. The first view is the view of the Hanafiya and the Malikiya. And it also is a riwayah of Al-Imam al-Shafi'i fi al-Qadim. What is that? They say it starts, Zakat al-Fitr's time starts from what? Tulu'u Fajri Yawm al-Eid.
Tulu'u Fajri Yawm al-Eid.
What does that mean? The Fajr of the day of Eid.
Okay.
That's the first view. The second view, they say, it starts, the obligation of Zakat al-Fitr starts غروب الشمس آخر يومي
Ramadan.
شهر رمضان. The last, what? The last day of Ramadan, when the sun sets, that Maghrib, as soon as the sun sets, they believe that's when it starts. Why have they got a difference in the issue? What's sababu khilaf? Why are they even differing on the issue? The khilaf goes back to this question, which is, هل زكاة الفطر عبادة متعلقة بيوم العيد أم بخروج شهر رمضان؟
Okay.
Is Zakat al-Fitr actually connected to what? The day of Eid, or is it actually connected to Ramadan leaving? Does that make sense? يعني Zakat al-Fitr, its purpose, why it was sanctioned? Is it connected to today's Eid, so Zakat al-Fitri, or Ramadan is over, and that's what it's connected to? Does that make sense? The ones who say it's connected to Yawmul Eid, that's why they say Tulu'u Fajri, Yawmul Eid. And the ones who say, no, it's connected to Bikhuruj Shahr Ramadan, they say Ghurub al-Shamsi, the sunset.
Okay.
And that which seems apparent, and that seems strongest, inshallah ta'ala, is Al-Madhhab al-Awwal, the first view I mentioned. Those who said it's what? بِطُلُوعِ الْفَجْرِ. That on the day of Eid, Fajr, that's when it starts. And the reason for that is because the Prophet said in the hadith, فِطْرُكُمْ يَوْمَ تُفْطِرُونَ. The fitr is what? The day that you do fitr, which is on that same day on Eid. That seems apparent. وَالْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. How many types did I say we have to categorize it into?
Three.
So I mentioned the time it starts. Now I want to mention, when is it obligatory for the person to do it? Yani, if I delay after this, I'm a sinner. In other words, صح? Yani, it's called waqt wujub ada'i zakat al-fitri. When is the, you have to pay now. If you delay it from now, you're sinning. There is three views. How many views?
Three.
ثلاث أقوال. The first قول is قول الجمهور, the overwhelming majority of scholars. And they say it is the day of Eid, the whole entire day. It's like the udhiyah, it's like the slaughtering. And they said it's not allowed for you to delay from the day of Eid, the whole day. The second view, let me finish. I know you guys have a lot of questions to ask. The second one is the qawl of the Hanafiya. The Hanafiya actually believe that the Zakatul Fitri is what? Mutlaqun, it's unrestricted.
So I can do whenever I want.
Whenever you want. That's the Hanafiya's qawl. They believe it's what?
Mutlaqa.
This is important. They believe it's what?
It's mutlaqa.
It's unrestricted. It's not restricted to any time. So the person can give it on that day or another day, no problem. That's what they believe. The third view is the madhhab ahli tahqiq. It's the strongest view. And it's based on the hadith. I want you to share with us, inshallah ta'ala, regarding the waqt and the time of Zakatul Fitr. What's the hadith, inshallah ta'ala?
أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمر بزكاة الفطر أن تؤدى قبل خروج الناس إلى الصلاة. أخرجه البخاري ومسلم من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما.
So as you can see in this hadith, the strongest opinion is what? The view of أهل التحقيق, which is what? It has to be paid what?
طلوع الفجر.
No, it should be paid before the people leave the what?
Before the people leave the prayer.
They leave the salatu. Salatul Eid.
So it's Fajr.
If Salatul Eid is prayed and you haven't given the zakat, what does the hadith say? فَإِنْ أَدَّاهَا قَبْلَ الصَّلَاةِ فَهِيَ زَكَاةٌ مَقْبُولَةٌ وَإِنْ أَدَّاهَا بَعْدَ الصَّلَاةِ فَهِيَ صَدَقَةٌ مِنَ الصَّدَقَاتِ. صح? It's just a sadaqah from the sadaqat. It has no weight. Now I want you to remember something. This action of not giving the zakat is a sin that you just done right now. تَآثِم. You're a sinner for not giving it. And this obligation, okay, pay attention here, this obligation of the zakat, it doesn't leave your shoulders. That's why you have to ask Allah for forgiveness, and you have to come with righteous deeds, and you have to beg Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to forgive you, and you have to give the masakeen their wealth and what they deserve. Because here I'm going to mention something very important. Zakatul fitri is different from zakatul mal. Zakatul fitri is connected to the people. It's connected to your existence. That's why we have to pay for you guys, because you exist and you're part of the existing ones, right? So how do you exist? Yeah. So everyone who exists, we have to pay Zakat al-Fitr for them. Sah? With the conditions we mentioned.
You're talking about Zakat al-Fitr or Zakat
al-Fitr? Zakat al-Malak is not connected to the person. It's connected to the wealth.
What do you mean?
The money, if it reaches a certain amount, that's when we have to pay from it. Like in Zakatul Fitri, you can be a person who only has what you need to eat for that day and that night, you have to pay Zakatul Fitri. You have the ability to pay Zakatul Fitri. If you have something to eat that day and that night, you have to pay zakatul fitr. You're not what? You're not a faqir. You're not a miskeen. You have to pay for it. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? Okay. The third, Ibrahim, let me finish. The third, remember how many categories did I say we're going to break the issue of the timing into?
Three.
How many have we done so far, Hatim? We've already done two. Walillah alhamdu. Wal minna. Now we're going to go into the third, which is, what is the ruling of ta'jeelu zakatul fitri qabla waqtu wujubiha? Someone says, I want to pay zakatul fitri before the time it becomes obligatory. I want to do it in advance. The Ahnaf, they see the permissibility of paying zakatul fitri 1 year or 2 years before it. They say, qabla wujudi sababiha, you can pay 1 year or 2 years in advance.
Zakatul fitr.
That's what they believe. Shafi'iyah, they believe you're allowed to do it and it is permissible to do it min awwali shahri Ramadan. When Ramadan enters and it's, we know that it's Ramadan today, you can pay zakat al-fitr. The Malikiyah and the Hanabila, they believe you can give it a day or two before it. They believe you can do what?
A day or two.
A day or two before it. Which is the strongest opinion? The last one is the strongest opinion, inshaAllah ta'ala. Why? Because it was authentically transmitted from Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that it, he said, وَأَنَّ عَبْدَ اللَّهِ كَانَ يُؤَدِّيهَا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ بِيَوْمٍ أَوْ يَوْمَيْنِ. Ibn Hibban al-Bayhaqi narrated this.
Okay.
That Abdullah ibn Umar, 1 or 2 days before it, he used to pay the zakat al-fitri. So you can send it to a country 1 or 2 days before, and they hold it, and they give it out. You could do that. Or you can even send it and it can be given to the poor a day or two before it. Does that make sense? That answers the 3 points I wanted to say regarding the timing of Zakat al-Fitri. What was the first point I mentioned?
The first point
was when does Zakat al-Fitri start?
Start.
The second point I mentioned was what? When is it obligatory for you to pay the Zakat al-Fitri? And the third one was what? Are you allowed to pay the Zakat al-Fitri in advance? And I've answered those three questions, right? Praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, Talha.
Abu, what is the amount of zakat al-fitri do you have to pay?
A very good question, mashallah. The zakat al-fitri, the amount that needs to be paid, hey, Ibrahim, share the hadith with us, inshallah. Miqdar al-mukhraji min zakat al-fitri. Hey, what is it?
كنا نخرج إذ كان فينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر عن كل صغير وكبير حر أو مملوك صاع من طعام أو صاع من أقط أو صاع من شعير أو صاع من تمر أو صاع من زبيب فلم نزل نخرجه حتى قدم علينا معاوية بن أبي سفيان حاجا أو معتمرا فكلم الناس على المنبر فكان فيما كلم به الناس أن قال إني أرى أن مدين من سمراء الشام تعدل صاع من تمر فأخذ الناس بذلك قال أبو سعيد أما أنا فلا أزال أخرجه كما كنت أخرجه أبدا ما عشت أخرجه البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري
رضي الله تعالى عنه.
رضي الله تعالى عنه.
This hadith benefits a few things that we can take from inshallah ta'ala. There's 2 points I want to take from here inshallah ta'ala. Is number one, miqdaru, I want to speak about the miqdar, meaning the amount al-mukhraj min zakat al-fitri. The amount that we take out from the zakat al-fitri. That's number one. And I also want to talk about wa hukmu ikhrajihi bil qima. And what is the ruling in paying the zakat al-fitri by what? By value. So those are the 2 points I want to talk about, inshallah ta'ala. Let's look at the first point, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, which is the amount of zakat al-fitr that needs to be given. Zakat al-fitr, the amount according to the Hanafiyyah, is nusf sa'in min burrin, half of a sa' of burr. Now, pay attention to this. I need to first of all explain what a sa' is. Sa' is arba'at amdad. And amdad is a plural of what? Amud. And what is amud?
It's
the palm of an ordinary person, like this. So 4 times of this, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's one sa' now. 4 amdad is one sa'. Half of A sa' is going to be how many mut? One.
Two.
It's going to be two, right? So they believe when it comes to the bur, it's nisfu sa' meaning two mud. Lakin when it comes to the sha'ir and when it comes to the tamar, they believe it's what? It's a sa'. So it's four amdad. That's the view of who?
That's the view of the Hanafiya.
The Hanafiya, they believe. The Hanaf, that's what they believe. And they go as far as to say, anything that you want to give other than that, you have to scale it based on those three. The bur, the sha'ir, and the tamar. So you first weigh the bur, whatever it is, that's how much of it you give. Are we all together? The amount, that the value it costs, do you pay that in what? The other things that you want to give. Does that make sense? Okay. Let me finish this point. The second is, the miqdar al-wajib عند الجمهور, according to the overwhelming majority of the Maliki and the Shafi'i and the Hanabila, is what? Sa'un عن كل فرد من جميع أجناس المخرج مما يعتد قوتها. مما يعد قوتها. Any food that's considered food to eat, that is edible, that people consider it as a qut, a food, they believe a sa' of it, whatever it is. This mas'ala is the first discussion. We're all together. The second point I want to talk about is what? Is it permissible? By the way, the second view is the strongest. Qawlul Jumhur, inshaAllah ta'ala, is the strongest. The second issue I want to talk about here is that, what is the ruling of giving zakatul fitri bil qima? I don't want to give food. I don't want to do sa'an min tamrin, wala sa'an min sha'irin, wala sa'an min... I don't want to do any sa'an. I just want to give money. I have money in my pocket, I want to give money. What's the ruling regarding that? Jumhur al-ulama, like the Jumhur al-Malikiyya, the overwhelming majority of the Malikiyya, the overwhelming majority of the Shafi'i and the Hanabila, what do they say? No. They say no. It's not allowed. Hanafiyya, on the other hand, يُفَضِّلُ الْحَنَفِيَّةِ إِخْرَاجِ الْقِيمَةِ. They say it's actually better to give the money. It's better to give money rather than the what? The food. Because they say what, the miskeen, if you give him the money, he can do what he wants with it. If you give him food, you're restricting him and you're limiting him. He may not want it. And where, again, I want people to know the sababul khilaf. Why is there even this disagreement? Again, just like I mentioned before, the sababul khilaf, I want to mention the sababul khilaf, the reason of differing on the issue. It goes back to two mas'ala. هل الأصل في الأحكام والمعاني الشرعية التعبد أو التعليل? The rulings in the Sharia that come to us, or the wordings that are used in the Sharia, the meanings that they have, is it ta'abbud, meaning we're worshipping Allah on it and we don't know what it is, we just worship Allah, or is it ta'leel, meaning reasoning? If we say it's ta'abbud, meaning we have to stick to what Allah and His Messenger mentioned, which is sa'an min tamrin, sa'an min sha'irin, sa', we have to stick to that if we believe it's ta'abbud. If we believe it's ta'leel, then if we say it's ta'leel, then we're going to say we can give it in value. And it's not restricted to what Allah and His Messenger said, we can give it in value. The second reason why there's this disagreement is zakatul fitri hal tajri majra sadaqatil amwal. Is it like zakatul amwal that you give? We already spoke about zakatul mal, right? Zakatul mal is connected to your wealth, it reaches the nisab, hala alayhi al-hawl, the yearly cycle went by, you have to give money from that money. Does it fall under that? Is it similar to that, zakatul fitri? Or am tajri majra sadaqatil abdan, which is kal kafarat? Is it like a kafara, the kafarat? You have to do it in the order that it was mentioned. You have to do exactly what it was mentioned. So again, it goes into this one. Whichever one you put it into, the ruling is going to become that. Does that make sense?
Oh. Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead, ask me, inshallah.
Abba, who did the zakat al-fitri go to?
There's two views in the mas'ala, first of all. The fuqaha, the jurists, they differ in this mas'ala when it comes to the masraf zakat al-fitri. And there are two views, inshaAllah ta'ala. Ibrahim's going to share the two evidences for each party. So the first evidence Ibrahim gives is for the first party, and then the second evidence is going to be the second party, and then we're going to discuss it, inshaAllah ta'ala. Now.
قال الله تعالى إنما الصدقات للفقراء والمساكين والعاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم وفي الرقاب والغارمين وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل.
So that's the first evidence. And here the second evidence for the second group is what?
فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر طهرة للصائم من اللغو والرفث وطعمة للمساكين. فمن أداها قبل الصلاة فهي زكاة مقبولة ومن أداها بعد الصلاة فهي صدقة من الصدقات. أخرجه أبو داود وابن ماجه من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما وصححه الألباني في صحيح الجامع.
So these are the two evidence. Barakallahu fik, Ibrahim.
The
first group, they say that the masrafu zakat al-fitri, the people who the zakat al-fitri have to go to, is the same as masrafu zakat al-mal. And as you mentioned in the ayah, there are eight people that have to be given to. And that eight people is referring to when it's zakat al-mal. And we already spoke about the difference between zakat al-mal and zakat al-fitri. Zakat al-mal is what? It's connected to the money, that it has to reach a certain amount and a yearly cycle has to go by. So the ayah mentions eight types of people it has to be given to. إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْعَامِلِينَ عَلَيْهَا وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ وَالْغَارِمِينَ وَفِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ. These are the eight Allah mentioned in this verse. But these eight is for who? It's the masraf zakat al-mal. It's not the masraf zakat al-fitri. Is not the the masrif zakat al-fitri. It's a masrif of zakat al-mal. صح? It's very important we understand it. The strongest opinion is, as you mentioned, the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, which mentioned وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. So it has to be given to who? The fuqara and the masakeena only. And it shouldn't be given to anybody other than that. And this is the madhab of the Malikiyya wal-Hanabilati ala qawlin. And it's the ikhtiyar of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. Wa huwa al-rajih. Because the hadith is mansus. The hadith clearly and categorically said what? وَطُعْمَةً لِلْمَسَاكِينَ. And I think based on those six questions that you all have asked, we've answered the rulings related to Zakat al-Fitri. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bimannihi wa karamihi that Allah bestows His never-ending mercy onto us. I also ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He forgives us for any mistakes, shortcomings, errors we have come with. And I also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you all. And to make you from the ulama al-rabbaniyin wa du'at al-sadiqeen. Does anyone have any questions before we conclude? Talha, do you have any questions? Hatib, do you have any questions? Ibrahim, you don't have any questions? So that is it, inshallah ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters. I hope you've all benefited from it, inshallah ta'ala. If we were wrong in anything we've said or anything we transmitted, then shortcoming is the nature of human beings. Only Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is infallible. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that He forgives us from any shortcomings or mistakes. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِي أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.